I feel like it feels weird saying at long last season 5 of Cobra Kai debuted on Netflix. But when you think about the rate that these seasons have been getting pumped out, you know, it really wasn't that long of a wait. But at the same time, when it's Cobra Kai, like anytime you have to wait for the next season is too long. So of course, season 5 debuted on Netflix last week, and it follows the main storyline, because there are always a bunch of different storylines, it feels, with Cobra Kai. But the main one is that Daniel LaRusso teams up with Chozen to strategically expose Terry Silver for the madman that he is after Cobra Kai wins the All-Valley Tournament under his co-leadership, and after he, spoiler, forces out John Kreese by framing him for a crime that he didn't commit. And again, as always with Cobra Kai, season after season, it manages to expand on what already makes the show great. Whereas the action sequences, the performance, and again, the characters in particular. I will say this 1,000 times until the show is done. This is a masterclass in character development more than anything.
Yeah, absolutely. This show just keeps on getting better. I don't know, like, that's something I don't think you don't see all the time with certain television shows. But I feel that with Cobra Kai, and other shows have done this, but like, after season 1, season 2, season 3, season 4, every season just keeps getting better. Mm-hmm. And it amazes me at how, this writing team, and even the directors, and even the people shooting them, just keep it consistent along the way and not lose the DNA of what makes Cobra Kai Cobra Kai. And even bringing in the old characters, you know, characters that we knew from the other, the Karate Kid films and etc., bringing them into the picture and expanding upon them as well, and even introducing new dynamics. It's so good. Like you said, this show is a masterclass in character development across the board with a lot of different characters, including even some of the side characters. I gotta give it to them as well. Mm-hmm. But overall, just because I just finished it essentially last night, and what a season. It was worth the wait. What a season.
And I love how, like, there's so many characters in the show. None of them feel like throwaways. I mean, they all feel important. They all feel memorable. They all feel essential somehow. Like, of course, you have, like, your leading characters, and you have, like, I feel like a lot of shows, like, have, like, your leads, your supportings, and then, like, you know, your minor or, like, really background characters. Like, I feel like this show really only has leading and supporting, because even the supporting characters that are in there, like, they feel important somehow. They all serve a purpose somehow. Mm-hmm. And I love how, again, they just manage to keep finding ways to expand and dig deeper with these characters without it feeling like fluff, without it feeling like something that doesn't need to be there. I think that's truly the most spectacular thing about the show. You know, whether it's a character, just like whether it's an old character, like getting an upgrade or a redemption, or, you know, even just like a newer character that you just keep increasing in the depth and you keep digging deeper and deeper and deeper.
Yeah. And to be honest, this show, especially towards the end, subverted some of my expectations, mainly because there were certain things happening a bit in the middle that I was like, oh, they're planning on possibly doing this, but they ended up not doing it, so I was kind of shocked at them not doing it, because I was like, oh, I expected this to happen, but I guess not. And one of the characters I really liked seeing grow was, you know, especially from last season, was the little, Man, I can't believe I forgot his name. The little black kid. Kenny. His development from last season to this season. And I got to give it to the actor, too. Holy cow. He's put on some great performances this season that made me feel like, oh, man. Like it was essentially I was feeling bad for certain things around some of the certain events around some of the characters. And just how the tables have turned with certain dynamics too. And I was just like, yo, I can't back this person or whatever because you're doing this. And it made me just think of just all the, you know, even some of the lessons growing up of just like, you know, you can feel a certain way, especially being bullied or whatever, but how you use what you've been taught that kind of defines a bit of your character too. And obviously there's also redemption. You see it with Robbie. I think he's easily one of my favorite characters in the show.
Yes.
And this, I'm not talking about this season, I'm talking about just throughout of Cobra Kai in general, from season one to season five, you just see how all of these characters have grown, matured, definitely matured, absolutely, to the point where it kind of just feels, to a certain extent, like, almost they're adults at certain points. And I'm just like, this is just really well done. But overall, this Cobra Kai season five, highly recommend it if anyone hasn't seen it. Obviously, I think a lot of people have already, but it was just, it was an emotional roller coaster, even for me, especially towards the end. And I was just like, this is great. This is just spectacular.
it's again, like, just when you think they can't possibly outdo themselves, they always do. And I just can't help but wonder exactly, like, what'll happen in season six based on the, I don't want to give like a spoiler as far as like how season five ends, but just when you think everything has been wrapped up, right? That like everything's been going on, like, you know, to the very last episode, you're like, oh, is this the end of the show? Then something else happens. You're like, oh, this still isn't over yet. And I still want to know what happens. But at the same time, maybe this prediction won't age so well. I have an odd feeling that season six will be the last season.
I was just about to say that.
I think season six, they haven't announced it, to my knowledge, they haven't announced anything like that yet, but I have an odd feeling that's going to be the last season because, again, there's a lot that's been wrapped up. There's still one more thing, again, that happens at the end of season five that obviously has to be handled, but I'm like, I'm just thinking to myself, where else can they really go after this? You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And I think, you know, if they ended at season six, then that would be perfect because, again, you know, we've talked about, you know, a lot of times on this show as far as, like, you know, certain series, TV series, running for too long. You know what I mean? And, again, I think the average, you know, really solid show has, like, about six great seasons. The average great show has about six great seasons. When you look at Friends, you know, seasons one to six, and then I'd say, you know, maybe season 10 are really the only ones that really matter. So I guess it's seven. Everybody Loves Raymond. You know, first three are fine, but the last six are even better. So I think that, again, Cobra Kai ending at season six would probably be perfect. And we've talked about with Stranger Things too. Again, season five for Stranger Things. No, and so that's when it's supposed to end. Good. Perfect. Because you can't have this go on for too long because I think that helps tarnish, not completely tarnish, but it helps bring down the quality of the legacy of whatever show when it runs for too long. So it's like, all right, like, come on, let's wrap this up. You're doing this for too long. You know, find something else to do. You know what I mean?
Yeah, absolutely. It's like a good story, you know, also has a great ending, but not only just a great ending or, you know, just wrapping up, you know, the character arcs and the stories that you're telling, but also leaves a great impact on a lot of people that is memorable for years to come. That's why we can talk about Friends, Breaking Bad years, you know, down the road because it left something. It was a certain legacy, and I think Cobra Kai is doing just that with the Karate. You know, it went from Karate Kid, you know, to now just an even bigger fandom with Cobra Kai, the inclusion, and just how massive that has grown. And I think, like you said, ending on season six, hopefully would be, you know, hopefully, like, that is the series finale, essentially. And if they end it with a bang, they end it with a bang, you know? Don't do another season. Just end it, wrap things up to the point where us as viewers can be like, you know what? It had a good run. Because to be honest, I did not expect Cobra Kai to go on this long. It used to be a YouTube special. And Netflix picked it up and got Netflix. I think it paid off.
Yeah, I think so too. I think so too. So for all of you that are with us at the moment, what did you think of season five of Cobra Kai? You know, do you think that the show's gone on for too long? Do you think that this season, like, manages to build upon, like, you know, everything else, like we've basically been saying? Leave your thoughts in whatever comment section that you can. And again, I just have to ask too, you know, did you enjoy our review of Cobra Kai? And if you want more reviews of your favorite newer shows like this one, like and subscribe wherever you're on YouTube or wherever you get your podcasts.